if you'd like to look it up, because a couple of you were asking. All right, we're moving on. Kathy says, hello, love the vellum too, it's so cute. Julie says, hi from New Orleans. Robbie, I love the font and the word die cut with the swirly ends, which is awesome. Let's see, Marin says, these are adorable. Just bought the tag set from Sandy, she's so excited. And Jennifer says, so glad I didn't miss the whole show, and I'm glad you're here. This is only, and we only do it a couple times a year, every Tuesday night for the month of October. Join me, 7 to 9 p.m. East Coast time, and we have all brand new items. Basically, I do have a really cool Christmas under 20, 5 and 5 coming up next hour. I have a This Day Only from Totally Tiffany coming up next hour. So there's even some more surprises you haven't seen. Of course, we've got our big surprise from Sara in just a moment. All right, guys, we have been busy already for this, and I get it. Here's my whole story, as I started to say. We give gift cards. It's something we do, but normally you get the gift card and then you buy the little lame thing that's, or you just grab the little lame envelope that's right beside it when you're in the checkout line. Don't do that anymore. Give a gift card with some real personality. It's your choice in this one of the Jolly Santa, which you're seeing the dies for that, and there's the stamps, and you're getting the stencil. Or the second choice is gonna be your snowman. So this is a big deal, Sara, because I don't know in England, but here in the US, everybody loves to give gift cards, but typically we don't do it very creatively.
Yes, exactly. And that is the problem. And that is the problem, Suzanne, that we've solved with this. Now, if you can't choose, you've got to go for both of them. Mm-hmm. How cute to do this. And then you see it's got the little holder for the gift card. And whether you go for the Santa Claus or the snowman, they both work in exactly the same way for you to then pop your little gift card into. Now, you can either do them just as little gift card holders like this, or you can start getting really creative and build them into your cards. Oh, so this is on the front of like a Z-fold card with the little gift card holders in there.
Right.
Or here we've even done, I mean, this is just ridiculously cute. This is little gift card holder on the front of a box. I mean, just
that's adorable.
Just so cute, okay? Isn't it lovely? Now, they all work on the same principle, so let me show you exactly how it works, okay? If I start with the Santa Claus first, this is the die set that you're getting to go with the Santa Claus. So what you get is, you get a load of dies, Suzanne, and then also this is just a template because it's nice and simple. It's brilliant, which is why we can do the whole set for just over $20, and it makes the full collection coming together. So what I've done is, I've started off, I've drawn around the template and folded together. I've used a little bit of red glitter card. That gives me the base cardstock that we're going to work into here. Now, I'm just going to stick mine together with a tape pen just for speed. So you're going to tape all the way down there, tape all the way down here, and that will give you the base holder for the gift card itself, right? Once we've got to this stage, you actually want to cut the gift card. So this is the die that's going to cut that gift card. So what you're going to do is you're going to die cut this. You're going to just lie it onto a piece of white cardstock. There's the piece that I've just die cut through. It comes out. Not only does it die cut around, but can you see it also does these four little corners to hold the gift card, Suzanne? So that has put those little tabs into the corners and done you, and then I've stamped the to and from. You've got the to and from stamps in there as well. That then fits inside here like this perfectly. So that gives you the kind of starter piece for your Santa Claus. And then you can see here where I've started to decorate it. All these accents, so this is his eyes and the middle of his belt, his beard, his mustache, all these pieces. And all I've done is cut them all together so that you can see if we want to decorate, you can do the hat goes over the top. Then you've got the base piece of the hat. And you can see it all starting to come together. You can do, I've done his face here with a little bit of colour. So what I've got is I've got the, there we go, there's his beard. His face goes on the top. You've got all the extra little pieces for his eyes are going to stick on. And all you're doing is basically putting it together. Now, I would say as well, Suzanne, this is a brilliant project to do with the kids. You know, that's if you want something a little bit
like
different, unique,
gifts. I think. I mean, how many kids, your kids gifts, are going to take it in teacher's gifts, get them involved in making these. They would love it. It would be so much fun.
Oh, and how much would the teacher love that as well, Suzanne? That's the brilliant thing for me. How much is the teacher going to love receiving a gift like this that the kids have actually made? So look at that. That goes on the bottom. Then you've got his belt. And then basically when the whole thing's ready, that's all stuck down. This version here, all I've done then is taken the gift card and put the gift card on the inside. So you're just going to thread that little gift card on, and it is the perfect size to go inside your Santa Claus. Let's have a little look. I'll get that in. Easier said than done. Back to front, upside down, live on TV, Suzanne. And that just slots into there, and you've got your little Santa Claus. And it's exactly the same whether you're doing the Santa Claus or the snowman. So the snowman works on just the same principle. Then all you've got is, I've added, he looks a little bit like the one out of Frozen, doesn't he? You've got his little carrot nose and his mouth. I've just took a couple of googly eyes on there.
Girl, you can't put enough googly eyes on things if you ask me. All right, so I got to give you some reaction. This is too. So Barbara says, oh, these are adorable. And Beverly says, shut the doors. These are so cute. Susan says, wow, what a great gift card. Need both Santa and snowman. And also, I love this. Fran said, a snowman family, maybe. How cute would that be? Christy said,
nice.
If you got real creative, you could use these for other holidays. And Christy, I was thinking the same thing, because she gives you the base, so you could just change up the face and you could just change up the hair or the hat. And if you are creative, you'll be able to figure that one out. Like, look, that hat could easily be a bonnet for Easter. You know what I mean? And then just change the face with whatever goodies you already have. Also, if you just want to stamp all over it, because she's giving you the dies and the mechanism to make that work. You don't have to come up with the idea. It's already automatically done. So, yes, I totally agree with you guys online. Christy, I think that's a great, great point. Patty said... Oh, again, Patty, if you look above, she's asking about my wrap. You can find it. We've got a link going there for my wrap that I'm wearing. Kathy says hi from Arkansas. Jana says this is very, very cute. She would love a reindeer gift card, thinking about using it for bedroom ornaments. Yeah, I was kind of thinking, Sara, too, wouldn't it be cute to hang them in the tree as ornaments and then tell everybody to go grab Santa, go grab the snowman, and then they open it up and they've got their gift card inside that.
Brilliant idea. I love that idea. Like you say, just placing these on the tree, whether it's the tree, Suzanne, or even what about having them as your place settings? Could be that this is your place setting around the table, and you have people's names written on it.
Oh, that's cute. Evelyn says, on a bottle tag, that would be cute, which is right. How cute would that be? You just slide it open, and it says, you know, thanks for inviting us to dinner or whatever.
Oh, ridiculously cute.
Oh, that's
ridiculously cute. And the thing is, Suzanne, I don't know about you, but at Christmas, quite often you go around to visit people and you don't want to take a present that's too expensive, you know, because you don't want them to feel bad that maybe they haven't bought you something. But what you do want to do is take something. So a relatively inexpensive bottle of wine with a little topper on like that is just going to look fantastic.
So cute. And then imagine if you took his beard and then I would add little cotton balls on it. Like, you can totally embellish the fur on his hat, the fur on his little dot. I mean, there you could just take this to sew. You could even put them in a whole different color way. I mean, think about this, Sara. If you use Santa, changed up the shape of the hat a little bit and made a tag for Dad for Father's Day and did a little tie and a little beard on him. Like, really, if you think about it, she's giving us the core pieces to be able to repeat this in a gazillion different ways. So you're going to have fun with this one. By the way, Santa's in the lead. If you want Santa, that is now the most limited. And then your other choice is going to be, of course, the snowman. Have fun with these. Again, you're getting the core basics. And I know you guys are so creative already online. You've got so many good ideas that you can have a lot of fun with these throughout the entire year. And you know, Sara, too, a lot of people do at the last second, they grab a gift card and then they are very uninspired. They throw it in a little basic card and hand it to somebody. When you make something like this, it just shows to me that you truly do take that extra step and you really care. And people will recognize that. Teachers' gifts, come on, please, do this for them this year. They deserve it, you know that. All right, Sara, we gotta wrap that one up, my love, and we're gonna keep moving on. I'm gonna mention this next time, and Sara, I would love you to give us about 30 seconds maybe on this. We had launched this a couple of weeks ago.